So hi all, today we will see this question. The question was asked yesterday in the POD. So the question is, Ghee collects the balls. So there are two parallel roads, each containing N and M buckets. These are the two roads and each road size is N and M. So each bucket may contain some balls. So these, all the elements in the array represents the balls in the respective buckets. And now the buckets on both the roads are kept in such a way that they are sorted according to the number of balls in them. So that is, they are sorted according to the number of balls, that is, they are sorted in increasing order. So Ghee start from the end of the row which has the bucket with a lower number of balls. That is, if the buckets are sorted in increasing order, then Ghee will start from the left side of the road. And the zeroth index would be the point where the Ghee would start its traversal. So Ghee can change the road only at a point of intersection, that is a point where buckets have the same number of balls on two roads. So in these arrays we might have some intersection points. So for these arrays I have 4 and 6 as an intersection point. So the first intersection point is 4. So whichever road I am starting with, I can shift the next road only from this intersection point and I have to collect the maximum number of balls. So see what is the question. We have three conditions. So first is we have to start from the left. Second is we have to maximize the number of balls. And the third is that we can shift the road only at the intersection point. So basically, if you see, how can we choose that which road to choose? Suppose this is the intersection point. So I have to be on either of these roads from starting till here, and now I can choose which road to choose next. So but which road to choose next, how will I choose? Since I have to maximize the balls, so I will choose the road which has the maximum balls in it. So let the balls in A would be 1 till the intersection point, and the balls in the B would be 5, that is 2 plus 3, 5. So whichever is maximum, that I will add it into my sum. This is how I can choose which road to choose. So now, since these are elements are same, so I have to choose only one occurrence for this. Now we have another road. Now the next intersection point is 6. Now either I have to be on this road or I have to be on this road. Now how to select which road to be traversed? So what I can do? I can again do the same thing, that again I will maintain the balls in A. Now the balls in A till the intersection point is 5, and here so it's nothing, it is 0. So now which would give me the maximum balls, choosing A road or B road? A road. So I will add the A balls in it and the intersection point. And now the rest of our elements are 8 and 9, which is maximum 9. So we will add this and the answer is 29. So basically this is the approach that we have to follow. This is a greedy approach and this will work for all the test cases. So what we are doing actually, we are maintaining the two variables. One is maintaining the sum of the balls in A and one is maintaining the sum of the balls in B. So till I have found the intersection point, I have to choose which road to be start with. So what I am doing, I am making two variables and I am storing the sum for that road in that variable. And now I have found the intersection point. So now I have the option to choose which one is the maximum. I can add it into my answer. So now how we can solve this? So we can solve this using the famous sorting algorithm, merge sort. So what does the merge sort say? If the current element in A is less than the current element in B, then we add this A element and we can update our I. And if this is a reverse condition, that is B is smaller, then I will add the B element in my array, sorry, in my B sum. Basically B sum is the B balls only. So we are doing this. So we are maintaining two different sums for two different roads, and whichever has the maximum, we are adding it into our answer. That is, if we have found the intersection point. So how will you say if we have found the intersection point? That is, if current element in A is same as the current element in B. then what we are adding it into our answer, whatever the maximum between the two. And after this, we will update our A balls to 0, B balls to 0. So this is what we have to do. There is one more case, which is if the array has a repeated point and that repeated element is an intersection point. So for example, the array has elements like 1, 4, 4, 4, 8, and the B has elements 2, 3, 4, 6, 9. So in this condition, what we will do, we will choose the last occurrence of the repeated element. That is, if the array has a repeated element, then we will simply keep adding that into the respective sums variables, or you can say A balls, B balls. And now when I found the last occurrence, then I will check for the intersection point, because this will help me increasing the sum only. Because if I choose the first occurrence only as an intersection point, then I will be having the less sum. That's why I'll be choosing the last occurrence of the repeated element. So now let us try to code it, and then we will dry run this on some other test case also. So what we have to do, we have to initialize two variables, one which is maintaining the sum for the A row and the other which is maintaining the sum for the B row, and the another which is maintaining the total answer that I have. And now in MerSort, we have to initialize our pointers as 0th. That is, we are starting our traversal from the 0th index. Now, till both the rows have buckets, that is, I is less than N and J is also less than F. So what I will do, first we'll handle the repetitive element case, because if we handle the repeating element case at the last, then it would consider the first element only as an intersection point. That is, if my current element in A is same as the current is the next element in A. But before that, we have to see for one more condition, that is, it does not lead to end of the array. That is, we shouldn't get the segmentation point. So what we will do, we'll simply add this into a sum of A variable and update our I. Okay, now we will do the same thing for the B row, that is, while this is less than M and B of J is same as B of J plus 1, then we will update our B sum with BJ plus plus. And now what if there's an intersection point, that is, if the current element in A is same as the current element in B, then whatever is maximum, we will add that into my answer. And the intersection point, we have to consider once only. So you can choose any, either A of I or B of J. And then again initializing our variables as zeros, again changing the values, that is it, and then updating the pointers. And now what if the current element in A row is less than the current element in B, then we will update our A sum with the current element of A. And else we can say that we will update the B sum. Okay, and now see, when we are out of this while loop, we are at the two conditions, that is, either both of them have traversed all of its elements, or there are certain elements left in either of these. So if the element in the first row is still left, then we will update them here. And if the elements in B row is still left, then we will update them here. And whatever is the maximum, we can simply add it into our answer. we will simply return the answer. So let us see. See, as the problem is successfully solved, and what is the time complexity for this? Since we are traversing the elements of both the arrays, that is, we are fully traversing the elements of A and fully traversing the elements of B. So time complexity would be n plus n, and space complexity is constant as we are not using any auxiliary space. So let us dry run it on the second test case. Okay, so this is the example test case that will dry run our algorithm on this. So initially what we are doing, we are initializing both the pointers from 0, and we have what all variables that I have. I have A sum, I have B sum, and I have answer. So currently my I and J both are at 0. So first of all, what we check, if there is a repeated element in A, no. Is there a repeated element in B, no. Then we check if the current element of A is less than the current element of B, yes. Then what we do, we update the A sum with the 1 and simply update our I. Now my I is at this and J is at this. Now same, is this repeated element, no. Is this the intersection point, no. Then we simply check, is this element smaller than this, yes. So we update our A sum and update our I. Now my I is at this. Is 3 less than 4? Yes. So again, update this. Now see, we have reached the size of the array A. So we have to get out of the while loop. And after the while loop, what we are checking, if there is any leftover elements, so we will update them. So see, we have still J0, which is less than M. So now we will do the iterations for the B array. So see, what we do, we simply keep adding all the leftover elements into the respective variables, so that we will update our B sum, then update our J, update the 5, then J is 2, update the 6, now the J is 3, but then now the J is same as M, so we are out of this loop also. So now we have the option to either choose this sum or this sum. So whichever the maximum is, we will choose that. So what's the answer for this? 3, 4, 5, 6. And what's the answer for this? 6, 5, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So which is maximum 15. So the answer would be 15. And as we can see, the output was 15. So this was about it. If you have any doubts, feel free to comment. Thank you.